Hey Cougars, welcome back to the Cougar Recap. I'm Akira Faith and I have two special guests with me, Athea Ali and Archie Sabtang. Welcome back to school, Cougars. Did you have a good break? Report cards will be distributed by Friday, March 24th for students to view. Instagrams are now for sale. To purchase, find a plus, peer resource student, or come to room 707. An Instagram comes with two Easter eggs filled with candy. There are one for $150 and four for $5. All purchases must be made by March 31st.
Prom tickets will be on sale until March 31st, so be sure to purchase them on GoFan, the office, or Mr. Baseman's room.
Remember that March 31st is also the last day to buy a yearbook for $85. If there are any extra, they will be $100.
Juniors, if you're looking to graduate early next year, you must complete an early graduation petition from your counselor. They are due on March 31. Wait, 31. Are you excited for Multicultural Week? Unfortunately, Multicultural Week is rescheduled to April 3 to 6 due to conflicting community events. But continue to look forward to performances from Poly, Mecha, and Boba Club on April 3rd from 5 to 7 at Multicultural Night. Clubs, are you interested in participating in a Multicultural Week? Go to the meeting on Monday, March 27th during lunch in Mr. Baseman's room.
On Tuesday, the Marine Corps Band performed for the Performing Arts, JRTC, first and second periods. So we're here with...
Hi, I'm Mr. Brown.
What is the Marine Corps Band?
Yeah, the Marine Corps Band is a service band made up of Marines who play instruments and they're really, really good players. Most of them have degrees in music. The performance went really, really great. Like, that's one of the best bands in the country, and we're super lucky to have them here on campus. So.
Did you enjoy it?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That was an incredible experience. Like, I hope the students never forget that experience. To me, that's like one of the most amazing groups that I could bring to campus, so I was really happy to do it.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Brown.
Yeah, thank you.
Now it's time for the fun segment. I'm here with Sandara. Okay. She's my sister. She's kind of slow. Oh, we can't say that. But anyways, so we're going to do, are you smarter than a fifth grade question, okay? Yes. Okay. Who painted Mona Lisa?
Me, because I'm a great painter.
Leonardo.
Okay, let's go.
I'm here with, I'm going to ask you, are you smarter than a fifth grader question, okay? What is the only letter that's not in the 50 U.S. states?
Q.
It's Q?
Yeah.
It's Q? Okay, good job.
I'm here with?
Mr. Turente.
What do you teach?
Psychology.
Okay, I'm asking a question. Are you smarter than a fifth grader?
Okay.
Who was the president before George W. Bush?
Before Bush, it was Clinton.
That's so easy. What is the capital of New York?
Albany.
Mm-hmm. And last question. What country has the longest border with the United States?
What country has the longest border? It has to be Canada.
Yeah. Okay, wait, last question for you. What is the one letter that is not in, that's not used in any of the 50 U.S. states?
Thinking X.
New Mexico.
A is Albany. B.
Alabama.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah,
it's right,
Alabama.
Q. Okay.
Thank you.
Wait, is that what you're going to put on there? You're not going to put all these?
It's a fun segment.
Yeah. We're going to put the whole thing.
I'm here with?
Mr. Winchidel.
Okay, I'm going to ask you, are you smarter than fifth grader questions?
I am not.
You're not?
No.
Okay. First question. What goes up but never comes down?
Go down a bit.
Your age.
Oh.
Okay, last one.
Wait, there's only two?
Yeah.
All right.
Last one. What is one letter that isn't in the 50 U.S. states?
An envelope.
No.
I mean, like, everybody speaks English in the United States, or at least a language, so there are a lot of letters used, like...
No. In the names of the U.S. states there.
Is there a state with a Z?
Is there a Y? I don't think there's a Y. Is there?
A what?
A Y.
A Y there is. New York?
New York.
No.
What?
You said without an A.
It's Q.
Weston Ranch boys volleyball has been doing great this season. They had a winning streak until they lost a tournament at Lincoln High School on Saturday against Granada and Antelope. Tuesday was their first varsity league game against Dyke, and they took that dub. I'm here with Abraham Palacios. He's an outside hitter and defensive specialist for the Cougar volleyball with an excellent hitting percentage of 538. Abraham, how did the game on Tuesday go?
Tuesday, I say it was a slow game. The team was, I don't know, I'd say there's better teams. There's better teams. Okay. But overall, it was an all right game.
That's good. How do you feel about the upcoming home against Gregory?
Against Gregory, personally, I don't know their stats or how they play, mm-hmm. but I'm hoping it's going to be a good game. I'm hoping for them to be the best.
Okay, thank you. Due to the weather, softball hasn't been playing many games. However, they will also be entering their SJAA regular season too.
Here's Elena and Maya on how she thinks the season will go.
I think the season is going to be very interesting. We do have a lot of strong girls on our team, so I feel like we will be putting up some pretty good fights.
It is Tinsley.
Yeah, what do you play?
I play shortstop.
And how do you guys feel? You guys are ready for the game tomorrow?
I think we're ready for the game tomorrow. It's our first game of the season, so I think we're prepared for it.
How's the team looking so far?
We're all right. We've had a few bumps, but I think it's going pretty well so far.
Go Adriel. And what events are you winning tomorrow?
I'm doing shot put and distance.
And how do you feel like you're prepared?
I feel pretty prepared. It's going to be cold, but I'm going to just prepare and warm up prior to my events.
But how's the rest of your team looking?
My teammates, everybody's doing good. We're getting medals at every track meet. So, yeah.
Up here. Okay, and that is it for the Cougar Recap. Tune in next week.